بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to talk about on-call problems with IV fluid. Based on what? Based on clinical base assessment and evaluation. هنشوف مشاكل المقيم أو نائب الأطفال مع المحاليل أثناء النبطشية or during the on-call time. During the on-call time. How do you can utilize the clinical skills to evaluate and to assess or to monitoring of babies receiving IV fluid based on what? Based on your clinical assessment in limited resources nursery or in ICU. Will not depend on biochemical or radiological or invasive like central venous pressure. It will depend on your clinical assessment. Depend on your clinical assessment and available resources. بيقول لك في المثل الست الشطرة بتغزل برجل حمار. فانت الوقت هتتعتمد على depend on your clinical assessment in limited resources nursery or in ICU to monitoring babies receiving IV fluid. We'll see here the assessment and evaluation of IV fluid depend on clinical, biochemical, even radiological and invasive. Invasive, it will be central venous pressure. So our lecture today depend on your clinical assessment and evaluation. So it will depend on the weight. So the weight loss or weight gain depend on urine output decrease or increase and depend on the evidence or sign of under or over hydration, volume overload or volume depletion biochemical assessment like serum sodium and urine specific gravity. Invasive like central venous pressure will not depend on this, just only I will depend on the clinical assessment to monitor babies receiving IV fluid based on the weight, urine output, and evidence or sign of under or over hydration. So we have six scenarios. During your on-call in ICU to deal with IV fluid or to monitor babies receiving IV fluid. Three scenarios depend on the weight. And other three scenarios depend on the urine output and weight. We'll take the first scenario. The first scenario, actually, you have to check the weight of the baby daily. You have to check weight the baby or you have to weigh the baby daily. If the daily weight loss is more than 5%, you have to increase the total volume of the fluid. By how much? You have to increase by 10 ml per kg per day. Body weight for one day to compensate for inadequate fluid administration. Full fluid or inadequate fluid administration. So this is the first scenario. You have to weigh the baby. And after that, you have to check the weight. If the weight loss more than 5%, you have to increase what? You have to increase the volume of the fluid by 10 ml per kg body weight for one day to compensate for inadequate fluid administration. This is the first scenario. The second scenario, the weight gain. If there is no weight loss or there is weight gain in initial 3 days of life, do not give daily increment and keep the fluid rate same as previous day. However, if there is excessive weight gain more than 3 to 5%, decrease the fluid intake by 15 to 20 ml per kg per day. So the second scenario depends on the weight. The baby weight gain less than 3 to 5%. So no fluid increment. It will keep the same fluid as previous day. So you will have to keep the fluid rate same as previous day. Specific or based on what? Based on the weight gain. But the weight gain actually it will be between 3 to 5%. So no fluid increment. The third scenario, it will be weight gain more than what? 3 to 5. more than 3 to 5. If there is excessive weight gain more than 3 to 5%, you have to decrease fluid intake by what? By 15 to 20 ml per kg per day. So you have three scenarios depend on the weight. If the weight decrease by or less than 5%, you have to increase the fluid. You have to increase the fluid by 10 ml per kg per day. If the weight increase more than 5%, you have to decrease the fluid by 15 to 20 ml per kg per day. If the fluid actually less than 3 to 5, it between 3 to 5, not more than 5, so you have to no fluid increment, no fluid increment, and you have to go by previous day, by the previous day. So we have the three scenarios depend on the weight. Weight decrease by 5%, increase fluid. Weight increase by 5%, you have to decrease the fluid. If between 3 and 5, you have to keep the fluid as the previous day. As the previous day. This is the depend on the weight. So we have to titrate IV fluid according to what? Sign of hydration. This is the three scenario. The other three scenario depend on sign of hydration, sign of overhydration or sign of dehydration, volume overload, if there is evidence of volume overload or volume depletion. So the hydration status I will depend on what? Depend on the weight and urine output and urine output. So we'll see the fourth scenario based on what? Based on the urine and weight. If there is sign of overhydration, you have to decrease the fluid by half for 24 hours. For 24 hours after the overhydration is noted, and you have to check serum sodium and urine specific gravity, and you have to titrate the fluid accordingly. So what is the sign of overhydration or sign of volume overload? It will be excessive weight gain, puffy eyes, or increase edema over lower parts of the body. Lower parts of the body. So the fourth scenario depend on the sign of hydration, overhydration or underhydration, based on the weight and urine output. If there is sign of overhydration, like excessive weight gain and puffy eyes or increase edema over the lower parts of the body, you have to reduce the volume of fluid by how much? Half for 24 hours after overhydration is noted. Then you have to check for serum sodium and urine specific gravity, and you have to titrate accordingly. So the fifth scenario depend on the urine output and weight. Urine output decrease and weight loss. This indicate what? Dehydration or defect or perfusion defect. So you have to increase fluid by 10 to 20 ml per kg. So if you will check urine output and the baby normally, it will pass urine 5 to 6 times every day. If there is decrease urine output and weight loss, you have to increase fluid intake by 10 to 20 ml per kg. So the fifth scenario depends on the urine output decrease and with decrease, both is decrease. This means dehydration. Decrease urine output, decrease with dehydration or perfusion defect. Defect in perfusion. So you have to increase the fluid by 10 to 20 ml per kg per day. The sixth scenario, and this is the last scenario, urine output decrease but the weight increase and the weight increase. This indicate overhydration or volume overload. Volume overload. So you have to decrease the fluid by 10 ml per kg per day, and you have to evaluate for what? Renal failure. You have to evaluate for renal failure. If the decrease urine output with weight gain, decrease daily fluid volume by 10 ml per kg, and you have to evaluate for renal failure. Because this baby urine output decrease and the weight is increased, this means having problem in renal problem. You have to evaluate this baby for renal failure. You have to restrict the fluid, you have to remove the potassium, and also and you have to assess the renal failure. So is the tuna, is zibda, al-khulasa, you have to assess urine output and weight. You have to check urine output first. If urine output decrease less than 0.5 to 1 ml per kg per hour, You have to check what? You have to check the weight. If the weight decreases, so urine output decrease, and weight decrease, both decrease, this means dehydration. They indicate perfusion defect. You have to increase the fluid. You have to increase the fluid. طب, if urine output decrease and the weight of the baby is increased, this indicate renal problem. Indicate renal problem. So you have to decrease the fluid. You have to restrict fluid and decrease fluid by 10 ml per kg per day. And you have to evaluate this baby for renal failure. You have to evaluate this baby for renal failure. So how to monitor babies receiving IV fluid? You have 6 scenarios. Depend on clinical assessment. Depend on clinical assessment. 3 clinical scenarios depend on the weight, and other 3 scenarios depend on the hydration status and urine output and weight. The first 3 scenarios depend on the weight. If the weight of the baby decreases by 5%, so you have to increase the total fluid or volume of fluid by 10 ml per kg per day. If the weight of the baby increases more than 5%, so you have to reduce the total volume or fluid by 10 ml per kg per day. If between 3 and 5, you have to no increment in this day, and you have to go by the previous day. And you have to go by previous day. So this is the first 3 scenario. The another 3 scenario based on hydration status of the baby and urine output and weight. If the baby having excessive volume overload, based on what? The baby having puffy eyes or edema or lower limb edema. So this volume overload or overhydration. This mean overhydration. What are going to do? You see here, this is a volume overload. You have to decrease fluid by what? Half for 24 hours after overhydration is noted, and you have to check serum sodium. If serum sodium is low, this is fictitious or dilutional, so you have to reduce the fluid. You have to reduce the fluid by how much? We decrease the fluid by half for 24 hours after overhydration is noted, and you have to check serum sodium and urine specific gravity, and you have to titrate the fluid accordingly. But here, the other scenarios, if urine output decrease by how much? 0.5 to 1 ml per kg per hour, you have to check the weight. If urine output decrease and the weight decrease, so this is dehydration. There is defect in perfusion. You have to increase fluid by 10 to 20 ml per kg per day. But if the urine output decrease and the weight of the baby increase, this is renal problem. So you have to decrease the fluid by 10 ml per kg per day, and you have to evaluate this baby for renal failure. For renal failure. ومن أحيا فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.